How many times a day do we do high five to a student? How many times do we say, you're doing a great job, you're working so hard? And so before writing, it's really important that we know what the students are writing about, that we've set a topic for today's writing, because otherwise I can't be informative. If I have no clue what you're writing about, I can't help look at what you've generated and give you informative feedback. But if I know that today you are writing about the fact that your mother was gone for 2 weeks, or today you're writing an email to your father and you want to tell him what you did this morning, or today you're writing about going to the movie Shrek, if I know that background information, then I can give you informative feedback. So before we write, we set up a topic so that I know what you're writing about. During writing, I do give you that reinforcement feedback. I tell you, I say, wow, you're really working hard. I don't do it a lot because I don't want to interfere, but I give you a little bit of reinforcement feedback. Afterwards, you stop writing and I say, oh, you did such a great job. And then I start looking at it and I give you evaluative feedback. For example, I look at it and I say, oh my gosh, look, you were writing about the movie and I see an M here for movie. Or I can say, oh my goodness, I see some letters in here that are in your friends' names. Point to a letter, and we're gonna see if it's any of your friends' names. And then the student points to the P, and I say, P, oh my gosh, P is for Patty. We gotta tell her, Patty, Jake wrote a P for Patty today when he was writing. So I can find ways to give informative feedback if I know the topic and if I know your life and I can connect to your life. It's way more powerful if we use informative feedback instead of just reinforcement feedback.